Education has always been a part of my life. My dad is a lifelong educator, and I see myself as a lifelong student. And what has been instilled in me growing up or encouraged is to educate yourself with what you're passionate about. Sometimes there might be some challenges and hiccups that come along the way. So I'm actually in this stage of my life. I will be going back to school to pursue my degree in education. I'm thinking of agricultural education of that sort. So. Just as far as, what has been communicated to me, as far as what my father, Dr. B, is envisioning is, really using this space as a space of peace, of refuge. I believe that the vision is expansive. So whether we're doing it here or over on Meadowbrook, I think the vision, connects as far as connecting yoga, agriculture, mindfulness, self-love or social justice, but really using the space to bring community together, to inspire youth, to inspire family. I think that's what it really is all about, is just reconnecting back to the soil through your soul, or reconnecting the soul to the soil in that aspect.
Why did you get into this?
It's always been a part of my life. It's always been integral to my life. I didn't initially embrace it because of like what my friends would say or think, or it wasn't cool. Yoga wasn't cool, agriculture wasn't cool, being a vegan wasn't cool, this is how I was raised. But I really started to embrace, I say this is a practice because it is a practice. It's something that you get good at. It's something that you have to practice every single day. it's the pulling of my ancestors, to be real. Like, that's what it is. It's really just the pulling of my ancestors, encouraging me to continue to continue to do their work initially, which is now becoming my work. Every time I come down here, I learn something new. In a sense, I really, really know how important it is to value the land, and we here take back the land. So, this land has been in the family for generations and generations. It's been part of our family for about 100 years now. For me, it was only right to, kind of take advantage of the opportunity. Like, hey, we have this land here. Let's continue the legacy of gardeners, of healers, of educators, in which my mom could probably tell you a lot more, of the history here. I'm definitely honored to be drawn and pulled by the ancestors, that once walked this land, and ancestral farms that we're, standing on now. My father actually participated in the first cohort. I participated in the second cohort, and then my stepmom, she, I believe this is the third cohort, that's maybe the fourth cohort, but she participated in the third cohort. So a couple of us have, you know, gone through the program. And I recommend it. I encourage, you know, whether it's the Lewis Ginter Urban Gardeners program or a Master Gardeners program, I definitely encourage that type, you know, that education. I encourage any kind of education that, you know, you're passionate about, because education is definitely a practice of restorative justice, of freedom, of liberation. I think it's definitely important to, especially if we are working on the land, it's definitely important to acknowledge those who have come before us. So a couple of weeks ago through the beautiful RVA connection, a lot of folks came out to the ancestral burial grounds to plant trees, and which I thought that was a beautiful thing, you know, just to kind of pay homage and create a space of beauty and refuge, solitude for people to go, but also be aware that, you know, this is a place of honoring, where we honor our, you know, our ancestors, our indigenous roots. So all of this is, you know, it's being uprooted through just the opportunity through this year-long project that has been afforded to me through initiatives of change, and their initiative is to disrupt spaces of racism. So I feel like, you know, I'm here in Richmond, Virginia. I'm a native of Richmond. This is my home. But there's a lot of healing that needs to be done here. And, you know, I feel like this is the biggest space in which people like me can disrupt with just what I'm passionate about: yoga, agriculture, giving back to the earth, and just receiving. Initially, I was asked to or invited to join the program, in which, you know, I mentioned earlier that you know, connecting to the land has always been integral to my life. But of course, as things begin to develop and evolve, there's always pieces or elements that are always added, and I'm always inspired to grab those different elements. So the Urban Gardener program really interests me because of the community trust building aspect of it. I really think that's important, especially if we're going to be going into communities, you know, trying to get a collective of people to come together to, you know, recognize and acknowledge why this work is super important. I think it's important to, you know, have that foundation of, you know, community trust building, and how do you create relationships within the work that you're doing, and how do you get people to resonate with that? So that's what really drew me to the program, was the aspect of the community trust building.